Hello there. Are you tired of creating websites that look basic and uninspired? Well, then it's time to level up your web development skills and learn CSS. CSS is a language that is used on almost every website on the internet to create amazing and responsive designs. You can change the color, size, and spacing of your HTML elements, add crazy animations and hover effects, and so much more. CSS will basically turn your boring-looking HTML pages into stunning and unique designs. Also, one of the most important features of CSS is the ability to make your website responsive. That means, using CSS, you can style your website in a way that it is able to adjust its layout to fit the size of different devices, like smartphones and tablets. Because at the end of the day, you want as many people as possible to visit your website. And since the majority of all website traffic comes from people using mobile devices, you really should take the time to make your website responsive. But before you get too deep into responsive web design, first you should learn the basics of CSS. And that's exactly what this video is for. Let's start with the syntax. In CSS, you write rules that define the appearance of HTML elements. A CSS rule is a grouping of declarations which are to be applied to one or more HTML elements. A CSS rule consists of a selector and a declaration block. The selector points to the HTML element you want to style. In this case, we are selecting all the buttons. The declaration block, created with curly braces, contains declarations that style the element. Each declaration includes a CSS property and a value that is assigned to it, using a colon. At the end of each declaration, you write the semicolon. Using this CSS rule, I can turn this boring HTML button into this button. In CSS, there are more than 200 different properties that you can use to style your HTML elements. But before you write any CSS rules, you need to know how to implement CSS in HTML. To show you this in practice, I've already created an index.html file. Inside the body, there's an h1 heading saying hello world. If you don't understand this code here, you should learn HTML before learning CSS. You can check out my HTML crash course video in the info card. Now let's style this heading. So, we need to implement CSS in HTML. There are three different ways to implement CSS in HTML. Internal CSS, external CSS, and inline CSS. Internal CSS means using the style tag in the HTML head. Inside the opening and closing style tag, you write your CSS rules. For example, h1 as the selector, and color red. Now we save the file and reload the page. We can see that the heading is now red. This is how internal CSS works. You just write your CSS code inside the style tag of your HTML head. External CSS is when you use an external stylesheet file. I recommend using this way to insert CSS. So, what you need to do is to create a new file in your project folder. You call this file style.css. It is important that the file extension is .css. Inside this file, you can write your CSS rules just like we did before. For example, set the h1 color to blue. However, in order for this to work, we need to include a reference to this external stylesheet file in our HTML code, meaning we have to tell the browser where he can find the styles for this website. So, first remove the internal CSS and create a link tag instead. The link tag is a self-closing tag, so it has no content and no closing tag. The link tag has the rel attribute set to stylesheet. Now we need the href attribute to reference the style.css file. Style.css. If your CSS file is in another subfolder, you would have to specify the path, but this is not the case right now. Now, when we save the file and reload the page, the heading should be blue. So this is how external CSS works. Why should you prefer external CSS over internal CSS? Since in external CSS, your CSS code has its own file, you can reference this file in other HTML pages as well. Meaning, if your website consists of multiple sub-websites and you want to style your sub-websites the same way, you would only have to reference the style.css file to apply the same styles. In other words, you write your CSS code once and use it as many times as you want. If you would use internal CSS, you would have to copy and paste your CSS code every single time for every sub-website. And the annoying part is, once you change anything in one style tag, you would have to change it in every other style tag as well to apply the changes there as well. This is why using external CSS is better practice. Now that you learned the syntax of CSS and how to insert it in HTML, it is time that we talk about selectors. Remember, the selector defines which HTML element you want to style. When we used button or H1 as the selector, we were using the so-called element selector. The element selector selects HTML elements based on their tag name. This selector will select every element that has this tag name. So, if I take button as the selector, these styles will apply to every button on the website. So, if I add more buttons in HTML, every button will look the same. But what if you want to style only one specific button and not all the buttons at once? In this case, you would use the ID selector. The ID selector uses the ID attribute of an HTML element to select this element. The ID of an element is unique within a page. For example, I can give this button the ID MyButton. To select the button with a specific ID, I use the hash character followed by the ID of the element, hashtag myButton. If I change the background color to red, only the button with the ID myButton will be red. The ID selector is used to select only one specific element. If you want to select multiple elements and apply the same styles, you would have to use the class selector. Just like the ID, you define the class name inside the class attribute of an element. For example, class equals big button. In CSS, you can select the element with a period character followed by the class name, period big button. In this big button class, I will set the font size to 42 points. If we save the file and reload the page, we see that this button is now bigger. The idea of classes is that now you can give any element that you want to be this big the class big button. Every button that has this class will now be big. Now you can create several classes for design settings that should appear repeatedly on your website. Then you give these classes to the elements that you want to style accordingly. But of course, you should not be using classes for every little thing that you want to style. Most of the times, it is better to just use a more accurate selector. For example, you can use the Descendant Selector. The Descendant Selector matches all the elements that are the descendants of a specified element, meaning it selects an element when it is somewhere inside the other element. For example, if I want to style a button inside the header, I just write header space button. These styles will only apply to buttons that are descendants of the header, even if there are other elements in between. As we can see, the button inside the div is also selected because it applies to all descendants. If you only want to style the direct children of the header, you would use the child selector, the greater than character. The child selector selects all the elements that are the direct children of the specified element. Header greater than button styles only the direct children of the header, and not the button inside the div. In CSS, there are many selectors that you can use to logically select HTML elements. Since we can't cover all of them in this video, here's a list of all the selectors if you're interested. Now let's talk about the third way of inserting CSS code in HTML. We have already talked about internal CSS and external CSS. However, there's another way to insert CSS code in HTML that you should definitely know of: inline CSS. Inline CSS is when you style each element individually. You do that using the style attribute. Every element has the style attribute that you can use to style this element. The declarations you write in here will only apply to the current element. Therefore, you don't need a selector. For example, I can set the background color to gray and the font size to 42 points. These styles will only apply to this exact element. However, this method of inserting CSS code is very bad. You should avoid using it, and here's why. First, it makes your HTML structure unorganized. These lines of code can get very long. Secondly, it's impossible to reuse this code since it only applies to the current element. Also, styling each element individually will slow down the loading time of the website, and therefore makes it unattractive for search engines like Google, which will punish you by not suggesting your website to potential users. And last but not least, inline CSS cannot be overridden by normal CSS rules, which makes it really difficult if you want to make changes sometime in the future. This is why I think that you should stick to external CSS. If you enjoyed watching this video and learned something new, you might also like to check out this video right here. Don't forget to like and subscribe to see more videos just like this one. If you have any questions or feedback, feel free to use the comment section below. See you next time.